Mavic 2 Pro, and they're actually quite easy to fly. If I can fly this, you can definitely fly it. So let's get out of this hot sun and I'll show it to you. Okay, much better inside. The worst time to be flying a drone would be 2 p.m. in Costa Rica in dry season. It is incredibly hot. So this is it. This is the DJI Mavic 2 Pro. I said Mavic Pro, I think, out there, but it's a Mavic 2 Pro. And as you can see, it's very compact. It's great to travel with it. I have taken it to a few places. I'm very new at flying drones, but I'm practicing every single day. So let me just unfold this and you can see it all folds out. When you pick it up, it feels like a very sturdy design. It doesn't feel cheap. And these are over $1,000 each, but they are really good. And you can get some incredible shots with it. The best part about it is all of these sensors that it's got on the side. So it's got one here, it's got some here. It's got them on the bottom as well. It's got them on the front, see, here and here. And also, I believe these are sensors too. They might just be lights. But it's got a lot of sensors, so when it gets too close to an object, it'll actually stop by itself. So they're really hard to crash. I've had two times where I almost did crash it. One time, there was a wedding here, a very small wedding, and I had just got this, and I volunteered to film the outdoor performance they had for the wedding. They had this fire dance. So there's probably about 50 people sitting around and I'm very cautiously flying around and not going near the people. And I was flying it in reverse and there was a wall, a concrete wall, and I actually accelerated and came in too fast so the sensors couldn't stop it in time. But it's okay, it didn't really damage it too much. And then the other time I was actually in Singapore and I wanted to get this shot of this place that I was staying, this iconic hotel. So I flew it there, I got all the permits and all of that to be able to fly it. So don't fly these in cities where you don't have permits. You're going to be very careful with that. But I was flying it around the hotel and it flew to the other side and it lost signal for a moment. So I've had a few close calls, but other than that, they're very hard to crash. So the camera on the front, this is on a gimbal, and DJI, they make a lot of stabilizers, so they've got really good technology around that. So this is the important part, and this is how it's able to get such steady shots. So I'm still learning about it, but if you want to get into making videos or filming, I recommend you get one of these. You can get much cheaper ones, but these ones, the Mavic 2 Pros, the good thing about them is they are quite hard to crash, so they're fairly safe. So that's that. It also comes with a remote and it just hooks up to your phone. So it folds out, you stick your phone in here, you've got these little screw-on joysticks, and so you get the app on your phone and you're able to see what the drone sees, and they're quite fun. So flying a drone is the kind of thing where you can get started really easily. You can get it up in the air and you can get some pretty amazing shots. But if you want to get really good, really skilled at flying, it does take a long time to master. And I'm certainly not there. I'm a beginner myself. But there's this one guy on YouTube called Sam Calder. I recommend you check out his channel. He's really skilled as an editor. And there's this one video he's got called Drone Highlights, I think 2019. I'll play it for you. It's pretty good, isn't it? So there's actually this whole community of people who make these drones, and they make them from scratch. They use GoPro cameras and they're completely custom, and they're able to fly much faster and they're much more mobile than the bigger ones like this. And they're just they take a lot more skill to fly. So I think that's what they're using in that video you just saw. But my point is, learning to fly one of these, it's like any skill that you want to master. It takes a lot of daily practice. And this was a lesson that I learned a long time ago. So I was 8 years old and I wanted to learn how to play the piano. And I ended up playing for a good 5 years and I was okay at it. I was actually pretty decent. I had a lot of different teachers, but the one teacher that stood out and which I'll never forget, she would use these improvement sheets. And it was like a calendar where you'd write your goal at the top of the sheet for the daily practice. So it might be 30 minutes, 45 minutes, an hour, whatever it was, you got to pick, but you had to commit to it. And each week she'd ask to see the improvement sheet to see if you had put in the time. Now, what was the reward? Well, that was one single Malteser. That's what you would get for a whole week. But that was something that I'll never forget, because if you want to get good at anything, it all comes down to daily practice. So when I think back over my life, any new skill that I ever learned where I got pretty decent at it, in the very beginning, I was terrible. I really was. My last company, which you're going to hear me talk about from time to time because it was my entire 20s, really. It's all I focused on. From a sales standpoint, it did remarkably well. And then it was sued in 2018 and it's now closed down, and that's a story for another time. But people often ask me, how did that get built? And the answer is, it was just daily, consistent, brick by brick, because all those skills that I had to learn in the very beginning, I didn't know any of them. So it was just a lot of practice. The hardest part is committing to the time frame that it's going to take to learn a new skill. And that's why I'm committing to 180 days to learn vlogging, because each day I learn a little bit more. Like yesterday when I was editing episode one, I didn't know how to animate text and have the text fly in. Now I know how. So you learn a little bit every single day, but unless you're practicing, unless you're putting into action this new skill, you're not making the mistakes and you're not learning. People often overestimate how much they can learn in the short term, but underestimate how much progress they can make in the long term. So just keep on going. So very soon I'm going to be launching a platform for people to help learn new skills. Now these will be skills in the creator space. So learning how to do video editing, photography, design, those kind of things. And also skills around the software for such creators. I'm then going to find the very best experts I can in each of those areas, and they're going to be the ones teaching. And I'm trying to figure out a way with the members area to replicate the accountability that I had as a kid learning the piano, where we had improvement sheets and we had to take daily action. There were targets and we got rewarded, we got held accountable. So I want to build that into the members area. Anyway, when I figure that out, I'm going to let you know. So don't underestimate what you can do if you practice daily. People always overestimate what they can do in the short term and then feel disappointed when they don't see progress. But they always underestimate what progress is made from long-term daily practice. The hardest part of learning any new skill is the first 7 days. But if you can make it through those days, then it gets easier from that point. So just remember, practice makes perfect. See you tomorrow.